FET, or frozen embryo transfer, is associated with an almost 10% better chance for pregnancy than fresh transfer. The benefit is thought to be in the preparation of the uterus. But what is the best way to prepare the uterus? Find out in today's episode of Infertility TV. In order to prepare the uterus for implantation, you need two hormones, estrogen and progesterone. Simply put, the estrogen makes the uterine lining thicker, and progesterone changes the lining so it can accept an embryo. The most common method for uterine preparation has a woman taking medications containing estrogen and progesterone to prepare the uterus. The estrogen is given commonly by a pill orally, but can also be given vaginally. Some doctors like to give estrogen patches or even estrogen injections. Progesterone is given typically as a vaginal suppository in combination with progesterone injections. Less commonly, doctors may choose to use the estrogen and progesterone that a woman makes naturally when she develops an egg and ovulates. This is known as natural cycle FET. Obviously, if a woman does not ovulate, this is not an option. Which way is better? Several studies have compared the two methods. As happens many times with medical studies, the studies did not all agree on the same conclusion. In other words, some studies indicated that natural cycle FET was better, some studies concluded that hormone FET was better, and some said it didn't matter. When this happens, we at Infertility TV will look for a type of study called a meta-analysis. With a meta-analysis, multiple smaller studies can be combined into one larger study. The greater number of patients studied, the greater the chance that you will get valid conclusions. So, in 2019, a group of doctors from Brazil performed a meta-analysis comparing natural cycle FET to hormone FET. In the end, the meta-analysis looked at five studies involving nearly 9,000 FET cycles. What did they find? Neither natural cycle or hormone-prepared FET could be proven to be better. Our Infertility TV bottom line: if you are planning to do an FET cycle, it's probably okay to choose either one of these methods. However, I will point out that doing a natural cycle can be much more difficult because of the close monitoring that is required to determine the exact time of ovulation. For these reasons, at IVF1, we prefer to do FET cycles with hormone preparation. For more important information about FET cycles, make sure you check out this playlist. If you like this video, remember to like this video. Have a question? Leave it in the comments below. Click the link in the description to become a new patient, or just subscribe to get new episodes weekly. It's like having an infertility specialist in your phone.